Here we are, we're in the car today. I'm going to be fairly quick because it's already 10:30 in the morning and I want to get in before all the broccoli-headed teenagers. Today is deadlifts. So I didn't get to train during the week. Work was just absolutely mad. So this is day three. Be a good workout today. So I have some targets that I have to hit or get very, very close to. I don't see why I shouldn't reach those targets. Hopefully I will. So heavy single today. Really, really building up for fire comp. So feel good. Well rested and fed and all that sort of stuff. So should be okay. It's just down to actually just getting in, warming up and getting stuck in. So it's a small, quick introduction today just because I want to get into the gym and lash in. I have a wife and a child to get home to. So anyway, see you in there.
First working set, squats, pause squats, three sets of six. So my squat isn't the best, so I only have 40 kilos on the bar. It's more just about keeping my glutes and everything active, because I'm not actively trying to up my squat at the minute. So see how these go. Yeah, they felt decent. Surprisingly felt strong on that. I'll probably up that actually. Go up another 10 kilos for the next set. I felt actually really good. So, let's see. Again, this is more about waking up all my muscles to get ready for deadlifts. Again, that felt fairly decent. I'll probably go up 5 more kilos. I'm up to, it's not much, 30, 55 kilos. It's not a big squat at all. I don't have big squats, but we're getting to depth. This is, I think, the heaviest I've done, 55 kilos. So I can't really complain at that. Again, very early on. Squat's something that I'm not really focusing on right now. It's everywhere else. So, but for me, it's about working on depth, because obviously you don't want to be caught on that in competition. But right now, form is king. So hopefully my form is decent. I'm not too sure. I'll have to have a look at this. It took me a long time to try to get close to depth. So it was actually a bit disheartening, but practice and a lot of fucking squats. Anyway, last set, 55 kilos for 6, paused. These are tough, so let's see. One more. Chuffed at that. Chuffed. Now, building up on the deadlifts. Be warned, my form is terrible, so. They felt okay. Form's probably dog shit, but we move up anyway. I have to work my way up to a heavy single, so. Yeah, 90 kg, we'll go for one. Okay, that was quick. 100 kg. My goal for today is 112.5, so well on the way. The 90 felt fairly quick, so see how this feels. Should be okay, should have plenty more in the tank, hopefully. So this is my big single for the day. It's 112.5 kilos. I'm not happy for sand, but I got to 115 before I started training with Laura, but the form was shocking. I was using belts and straps and everything else. It's all artificial, not artificial, but it gives you an edge. So this is completely raw. It's grip strength, no belt. So, let's see. Come up. It come up. Have to be happy with that. Felt myself tip forward a little bit, but each week we're getting stronger. Couldn't have done that a few weeks ago. Yeah. So that come up fairly easy now. Now we're down to three heavy singles at 102.5 kilos. So drop by 10 kg. Let's see. Crazy. Squats and deadlifts. According to this, I'm training in a half an hour. I've already burned 350 calories. It just goes to show you how intensive the work is. Your heart rate gets absolutely jacked. Yeah. Happy with that. Very happy with that. Yeah, just adjust the camera angle a little bit. By the way, I'm using an Osmo Pocket 3. If you're looking to record anything, amazing. It's small. You could use a tripod if you want. It has a little built-in tripod. I'll probably get one just to help with the angles. But you can direct everything with your phone. It just saves me having to fuck around with the actual gimbal. It's great. It's like having someone in the gym with you to help you record. Last one of these, and then it's on to deficit deadlifts, dropping the weight to 85 kilos, sets of 3, reps of 5. Just take that time, reset the whole time, lash this one. Deadlifts. Now, so my plan says to do 85 kg, but Laura, please don't hate me, I'm actually feeling fairly strong. I'm gonna bump up to 90. I should be okay on that. She's probably gonna kill me because it's probably on next week's, but honestly I feel strong, so felt good. Second set. Yeah. Now, last set it is, and then it's on to RDLs, Romanian deadlifts. I have a choice I can do with dumbbells or barbell. Personally, I prefer barbell. So, it's probably the one thing I'll break the straps out for. Just have a few pull exercises today, so just don't want to destroy any grip for everything else. So, see how we go. Yeah, after this I actually have hamstring raises, but the piece of equipment is actually very close to the door, so it's a high traffic area, so I won't be able to set the tripod up for that. Just don't want my camera getting kicked over. So that is, it's not very heavy, it's going heavy, but it's 3 sets by 5 reps, so really slow and controlled. An explosion on the way out, so I'll see what it's like with people walking in and out. If I can, I will. Difficult to record in here. It's getting fairly busy, so my camera was knocked over, so I'm just getting a bit paranoid about that. Just I don't want anybody breaking. Did my hamstring raises, went fairly well. And now I'm on to leg press. I'm up to the new PR. Either side, 70 kilos. 140 kilos on either side. So I'm happy with that. So can't complain. Bit of camera glare in here, but be okay. If I can record anything else, I will. The next is lat pull down and rows anyway, so see how we go. Here we go. So a little bit quiet here. Let's start at 40 kg, so this is 4x20, so squeeze every rep, so it can get quite intense. Let's see. Seated rows are harder when you're doing them like that. Much harder. There we go. 3x8. Heavy as fuck is literally what it says on my plan. So I'm going to start at 80 kilos. I'm gonna drop this by 5 kilos because I nearly didn't make that, so my arms are starting to gas as well. Last one. I'm gonna drop it again. It's around 70 kilos, which is still decent for a lap hold now, I think. Don't know what I'm gonna drink. There you go. Drop it to 55. Do a few extra. There you go. Well and truly fucked. Yeah, there we go. So it was a good 2 hour session today. Overall, extremely happy, extremely happy. Pulled my 112.5, and I felt like it went quite easy. Like, obviously it was a bit of an effort, but you know, smooth. I'll have to have a look at the video for form wise. I know for me, my hips tend to shoot up first before the bar comes off the ground, which isn't the best, but it's something that's probably too late to fully correct right now, you know, talking to Laura and stuff like that. So it's a case of just protecting me back, making sure my back is straight for the day of competition, which thankfully it is. It's just about being mindful of my hips. Overall, everything went very, very well. Unfortunately, I couldn't film everything. There's other people in the gym, so you have to be respectful of that. And I got quite busy. My camera was actually knocked over at one stage. It was an accident. The guy turned around and apologized. It is what it is, you know, these things happen. He stepped in to get away and accidentally hit the camera. It's just unfortunate. So I put the camera away because where I was quite busy at the time. It's one of those things that can happen. This is what happens when we film in the gym. So you have to be careful of other people. And you have to be respectful of other people. So obviously the space doesn't belong to me. It's not my gym. It's a public gym. People use it. It is what it is. No point getting annoyed about it. The only thing is, obviously, I was like, oh shit, my camera. But nah, it's fine. Anything else? Everything I went heavier on, which is good. My lat pull downs, I had to use a different bar today. I usually use like a, I'm not sure what the name of it is, but essentially it's a narrower grip and you just kind of hold it like this and you pull. You can get it closer to your chest. The one I was using today is, I think it's more for like a seated row, because the U in it is quite wide, so it's obviously to enable you to pull straight in. I couldn't get it down all the way, but I felt my lat engaging and I'm happy with how the weight progressed. So I went from 80 kg for A down to 75 kg for, I think, A. And then down to 70 kg for 4 or 5, and then I lowered down to, I think it was 65, and just repped out. So I'm happy with that. You didn't actually get to see it, just because where I was doing my hamstring raises is kind of a high traffic area. Same thing, felt strong on that. Did all my reps and sets without any complaints. So next week I'll probably up that in the weight anyway. Deficit deadlifts, on my plan it was 85 kg. I actually felt really strong, so I upped it to 90 kg. So that was, I think, 3 sets of 5 reps, and honestly every one of them felt really, really good. Towards the end I was getting tired, so I was a little bit slower off the ground, but that's going to happen. That's kind of what you want to happen. You want to feel that and you want to be able to get it. You want to, you know, you want to have that little bit of struggle. If it's too easy, you know, you're not pushing yourself. So now I felt really, really strong today. I've been sleeping, which is important, and eating well. So that's obviously contributed to my training. My weight, I actually haven't weighed myself this morning. I'm going to weigh myself on Monday morning. I usually weigh myself most Mondays. I'll probably have to start watching my weight midweek, but I was 103 kilos 2 weeks ago, and I weighed myself kind of sometime last week or midweek or something like that, and it was 99 kilos. For me, it's not about losing weight right now. I'm looking ahead for, you know, more powerlifting meets and stuff like that. And it looks like I'm probably going to slot into the 103 kilo weight class, which suits me fine, because I don't want to, one, put weight on, and two, I don't want to lose any more weight. I'm happy with how my body feels. It's about how I fill out the skin that I'm currently in. And honestly, right now I'm very, very happy with where I'm at. So, yeah, I'll probably, going forward, if I'm taking my training, which I am taking it seriously, taking it more seriously and going for full-blown competitions, obviously at a novice level, I'm not sure when kind of the weight categories come into play, but I've been eyeing that up and I want to stay in the 103 kilo weight range if that's the correct range for me. As I said, I don't want to suck any more weight, and I especially don't want to be cutting weight either the day of or the day before competition for weigh-ins. Coming from a fan's aspect of an MMA background, I see what weight cut can do to people, and I've seen drastic weight cuts in the past, so it's something that I very much would like to steer clear from. And obviously with my own body issues and all that sort of stuff, me trying to fixate on a weight probably isn't going to be quite good for me. So I'm just kind of happy to compete where I'm at. I'm not looking to push much further than that. Anyway, as you can see, I'm still a sweaty mess. I haven't showered yet. I went in to have a shower and then realised I forgot my shampoo and shower gel. So I forgot that I was out with them last week and I didn't refill my bike. So I'm going to head home, have a shower, spend some time with the amazing women of my life, and edit this video. So I'll be back training tomorrow morning. Tomorrow is predominantly a push day, shoulders, which I love. So I think I have a bit of bench in there as well. Can't remember. Doesn't matter. Tomorrow will be that anyway. And yeah, stay positive. Have a good weekend.